Good evening. My name is Michael Odupitan, and I am the CEO and president of Omni Circle. It took me almost 30 years to really get to the understanding of what Juneteenth was. I never had an opportunity to really be, you know, to explore Juneteenth, to actually understand what Juneteenth was and what it meant to us as a people. But it took me roughly to around 32 years old before I really dove in and had an opportunity to really understand the true nature of Juneteenth and what it meant to us as a people. I think my knowledge of Juneteenth came around the time when I started to really dive into our history. I think I was about 32, 33 where I really sat down and I did a timeline of African-American history because I was at a point where I just wanted to know everything from the beginning to the end. And I started to dive in and to try to understand who we were as a people. And as I was going through the timeline, I came across Juneteenth and had an opportunity to understand what it meant. You know, going through, when you look at, you know, when slaves were freed through the emancipation, and, you know, at a point where we thought that everybody was free across the country, but the information about our freedom did not get passed down to those who were in Texas. So we still had slaves at the time in Texas, slave owners still functioning with, you know, their slaves when we were at a time when we should have been free. Like I said, I understand from what my knowledge is that somewhere there was a mix-up as far as the information getting passed down to the slaves, but I'm sure once they got the information, it was time to go and to release them chains and to do something a little different. So I know that there was a point, you know, at that time when we said, okay, well, we needed to declare that this was the day in Texas that we wanted to declare our freedom. So Juneteenth was the day that we did that, and it became a celebration. A lot of people celebrate 4th of July, and a lot of people are unaware that, you know, 4th of July was not a celebration for African-American people. We were still slaves during that time. So to understand that, you know, our true emancipation, our true freedom for all slaves, and I would say for all slaves because, like I said, the information didn't get down to Texas soon enough for them to be free as well. Juneteenth was a day that we celebrate for all the freedom of all black people. And I would say as far as celebration goes, I really didn't start to celebrate Juneteenth until I moved to Topeka. We had a number of festivals that we celebrated when I was growing up in Florida. But Juneteenth was not one that we really dove into much. But it was not until I moved to the Midwest and was able to explore the culture here in Topeka, and Juneteenth was a celebration that, you know, goes on every year here. So I'm kind of glad that Topeka had, you know, gave me some of that exposure as far as the celebration. And that's pretty much what my knowledge and my celebration and how we do it. I mean, every time, you know, Juneteenth comes, it's always a time for us to barbecue and, you know, get together with our friends. And I hope, you know, this message reaches somebody else, and hopefully we continue to, expand upon the conversation and learn more about the history of Juneteenth and why it's important for all African-Americans to celebrate this day.